6x cos to the power 6x by sin square x cos square x. There is no quotient rule that you can apply here. So the things which make integration difficult is lack of rules. There is various rule. You have to rely mostly on improvisation, right? And secondly, it is not rule driven, or you cannot follow a simple set of conventional methods to solve them. Tan x minus cot x minus 3x. Yeah, apart from this, is anybody to do it? You can only use the formula which I have given you. If any extension is there linearly, you can manage with the same formula. But any other version, do not try to extrapolate from your end. That means if you know sin x integration is minus cos x, that doesn't mean sin square integration, sin square x integration will be minus cos square x integration. Nothing like that. Okay, let's see how we do this. Okay, first of all, numerator has a cube plus b cube. Can I say a cube plus b cube is a plus b whole cube minus 3ab a plus b? And you know a plus b is going to be 1, correct? So it's going to be 1 minus 3ab, correct? So here I can write 1 minus 3, in fact, let me divide it by ab also. So a cube plus b cube by ab would be 1 by ab minus 3, correct? So this is a cube plus b cube by ab, correct? So it's going to be 1 by ab, which is sin square x cos square x minus 3. Is this understood so far? Correct? Now this one, can I write it as sin square x plus cos square x? Correct? Let me individually divide sin square by the base and cos square by the base. What will I get? 1 by cos square x plus 1 by sin square x minus 3 dx. Yes or no? What is 1 by cos square? Sec square. Plus 1 by sin square? Cosec square. Are we aware of integration of sec square?
Yeah.
What is it?
Tan x.
Tan x. Are we aware of integral of cosec square?
Yes.
Minus cot x. Are we aware of integral of minus 3?
Minus.
This is your answer. Integrate cos x minus cos 2x by 1 minus cos x. What is the answer?
2 sin x plus x plus c.
2 sin x plus c, correct. Those who have done that, try this one. Who has not said? First one done. First one, we can write cos 2x as 2 cos square x minus 1, correct? If you open the bracket, it becomes plus 1. I think it is factorizable. So I can factorize it as minus 2 cos square x plus 2 cos x minus cos x plus 1. Which is, take a factor of minus 2 cos x. Okay? Now the factor of cos x minus 1, and this will go off leaving a positive sign. Right? So ultimately you are integrating 2 cos x plus 1. Integration of 2 cos x plus 1 with respect to x would be 2 sin x plus x plus c.
This proven that limit and integration
can be reduced. Okay. Integral of limit is limit of integration.
Yes.
But
doesn't work for us.
Right, correct. So second one is even easier. For second one, you just have to write this as 2 by 5 to the power x plus 3 by 5 to the power x dx. So it's like a to the power x form, correct? So its integral is 2 to the power 5 x by ln 2 by 5, and integral of this is 3 by 5 to the power x by ln 3 by 5 plus c. Now we'll start our very important method of integration called method of substitution. I personally feel that this method is the heart and soul of integration. Almost 70-80% of the problems would require substitution of some or the other kind while solving the problem. Now why do we use substitution in solving integration problem? Because we don't have enough rules. So we mostly have to bring a problem or reduce a problem to a standard function which we know how to integrate. So as we saw, there was a list of integrals of some standard function. So in case we need to solve a problem which is beyond those standard functions, we need to use some substitutions in order to make it resemble the standard integrals that we have learned. Correct? So what we do, depending upon the question, again, there is no rule for it that you have to always substitute this as this. Except for here and there are some well-defined rules. But depending upon the question, we take a part of the function as another variable. Right? Please note that when you are substituting the part of a function as another variable, ultimately you have to convert the whole function along with dx in terms of that variable. And that choice of the variable or choice of the part of the function will be mostly driven by the question itself. Okay. For example, let me start with simple integral of tan x. Okay. Now tan x, there is no integral directly, we do not know of any function whose derivative is tan x. Correct? So by the antiderivative formula, we cannot find the integration of tan x. But I know tan x can be written as sin x by cos x. Okay. And we can see that the derivative of cos x is sin x. Okay. So what do we do in this case? We substitute cos x as t. You can choose any name of the variable, u, p, k, whatever. Now what is the benefit of this? If you differentiate cos x, which is minus sin x, you will get minus sin x is equal to dt by dx. Correct? Take the dx on the left side, you get minus sin x dx is equal to dt, which means sin x into dx is minus of dt, which implies you can substitute not only your cos x with t, but sin x dx with minus dt. Correct? Minus, as I already told you, the rule says if there is a constant, you can pull it out of the integral. Now 1 by t It resembles 1 by x, integral 1 by x, which is ln mod x. So in a similar way, the integration of minus 1 times integral 1 by t dt will be minus 1 ln mod t plus c. Now you can't leave your answer in terms of t, because t is something which you introduced into the problem. So replace it back by ln of mod cos x plus c. By using the property of log, this can come as a power over here. So you can write it as ln mod cos x inverse plus c, which is ln mod sec x. So this is a very small example where method of substitution is helping us to find the integral of otherwise unknown integral, correct? So please, going forward, remember this result also. You can add it to your formula list wherever you have written the formula for integral of standard functions. Integral of tan x is ln mod sec x. I think the other day in application of derivatives, this appeared. In a similar way, can you attempt integral? Hello. Can you attempt integral of cot x? Integral cot x with respect to x. So basically, the choice of the variable, or the choice of which function to put it as the variable, depends upon what do you observe in the function. I observe that if I take cos x as t, then sin x dx is going to behave or will be related to minus dt, and that help us to solve the integral. Is this a Dipanjali? Can I raise this? So please remember the result. Integral tan x is ln mod sec x. Yeah, what do you do in this case? We write it as cos x dx by sin x, correct? What do I substitute here?
Sin x
as t. So sin x as t, that means cos x will be dt by dx, which implies cos x dx is dt. So this entire integral converts into, this term will become dt, this term is t, so it will become ln mod t plus c. Put back your t as ln sin x plus c. But very important thing is that I have seen many people, they just convert the function in terms of t and dx, they forget. That should not happen. Everything along with dx must also be converted in terms of the new variable. Are you getting it? Next, try integral of sec x. Now with sec x there will be some problem, because sec x requires a special treatment. So in case of sec x, what do? We multiply and divide with sec x plus tan x. Okay. The main reason for doing that is, you would realize by doing so, you would get the derivative of the denominator on the top. Do you see that? Sec x derivative is sec x tan x, and tan x derivative is sec square x. So this facilitates us to substitute sec x plus tan x as another variable t. Differentiate both sides with respect to x, you get sec x tan x plus sec square x is dt by dx. Take the dx on the left side. So you realize that this entire term would be dt and this term would be t, correct? So it reduces to the integral of dt by t. Now you must be thinking, every time I am getting 1 by t only. Just by coincidence. Okay. So which will be ln mod t plus c. which is ln secx plus tan x mod plus c. Now many times what will happen when you are solving problems and when you check the answer at the back of the book, you would realize that some different function is given in the answer. For example, many times the integral of secx is given as ln tan x by 2 plus pi by 4. And then it makes you feel that, oh, probably I've done something wrong in my this thing, and you recheck your answer and everything. But please note that it's just that they have simplified it further by using trigonometric identities to write secx plus tan x as tan x by 2 plus pi by 4. I'll quickly show you how it comes. So secx plus tan x, you can write it as 1 plus sin x by cos x. 1 plus sin x can be written as cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2 whole square. And cos x can be written as cos square x by 2 minus sin square x by 2. Correct? I can factorize the denominator as cos x by 2 minus sin x by 2 times cos x by 2 plus sin x by 2. So one of them will get cancelled. Then divide throughout with cos x by 2, you will get 1 plus tan x by 2 by 1 minus tan x by 2. This is clearly the formula of tan pi by 4 or tan x by 2 plus pi by 4. So many a time they will simplify it like this and present it to you. So you should know all the versions of the answer. Somebody was asking me during the break, how do I know where to stop my answer or in what form should I present my answer? See, in case of JEE exam, options would be given. So you have to bring it to that form which the option is demanding from you. In case of board exams, multiple answers are provided to the examiner. Right? So even if you leave it at this form, they will not penalize you for that. You can also write the same answer as minus ln secx minus tan x plus c. Because secx minus tan x reciprocal is going to be secx plus tan x. Do I need to tell you how? In a similar way, in a very similar way, almost the same way, try to integrate cosec x. And before that, please append your formula list, add these three formulas for integral of secx. This one, see, we know that secx plus tan minus tan x, this is equal to what, correct? So you can factorize this as secx plus tan x into secx minus tan x. So you can also write secx plus tan x as 1 by secant x minus tan x. Correct? So this term I can write 1 by this. 1 by this means power of minus 1. So log properties minus 1 will come now. Yeah. So this was ln of secx plus tan x. So ln of tan x. Yeah. For this, what do? We multiply and divide with cosec x minus cot x. You could multiply with cosec x plus cot x as well, no problem. Okay, so the benefit of doing that is you would realize on the numerator you get cosecant square x minus cosec x cot x. Okay. And if you take cosec x minus cot x as t, you would get minus cosec x cot x plus cosec square x as dt by dx. Take the dx on the other side, and this exactly becomes your numerator of the function here. So your integral becomes dt by t. Again, coincidentally, t. So ln mod t, so which is ln mod cosec x minus cot x plus c. Again, when you turn your book, don't be surprised if you see the answer written is ln tan x by 2 plus c. By the same process, you can also reduce it to this. And it can also be minus ln cosec x plus cot x, as what Aditi told. This is also correct. So earlier when we were doing the integral as antiderivative, we did not know the formula for tan integral, cot integral, sec and cosec, but now we know the formula. To be remembered, you will not get a chance to derive it. Let's take problems based on this. Minus ln cosec x plus cot x, ln tan x by 2. Let's take problems based on method of substitution. For the next 1 hour or so, we'll take problems on substitution. First, let us start with this problem. Integral of cos x plus x sin x by x times x plus cos x. Third question, I have written 3 questions in it because they are of the same type and it may be a potential question for you in school also, where A, B are constants. Ln mod of x by what do you
x square plus x cos x plus c.
Second one is first one, anybody? Please practice a lot because I always get to hear from the students, sir, every problem I solved, only the integration I could not do in the exam. I got stuck. Because some of them are very, very step specific. If you don't follow those steps, for example, integral of sec x. Right? Had you not multiplied with sec x plus tan x, it would have become nearly impossible to solve that problem. So they are very much specific types of integrals, which will only come through practice.
I cannot have a half half x half half.
Yeah, that's a great problem. Your convergence should be completely in terms of t, whatever name of the variable you choose. All right, we'll do the first one. See, first of all, x plus cos x is there, so what I'll do, I will write it as cos x plus x and I will subtract x also. Correct? Can I do this? So I added an x and subtracted an x. What is the benefit of doing this? I can just divide this individually by this, I will get 1 by x. And if I divide this by this, I will get, by the way, x will get cancelled with this, so I will get sin x minus 1 by
x plus cos x.
Now, this is safe. This you can integrate as ln mod x, right? What about this? In this integral, I can substitute x plus cos x as t. So 1 minus sin x will become dt by x. Dt by dx, which means 1 minus sin x dx is dt. Guys, going forward, I will directly write from this step to this step, okay? This step I will not be writing. just because the first class of integration, I'm writing those steps. Going forward, nobody writes this step. Directly, we'll write this step. So can I say the numerator would become minus dt by t? Yes or no? So minus dt by t, your answer would be this ln mod x. I am copying as such. Answer for this will be minus ln mod t plus c. So put back your t as x plus cos x, and this is your answer. Again, very unconventional. I mean, even if you practice, you will not be able to realize that there is a different hidden way to solve this problem. I personally solved around more than 1000 integrals in a matter of 2 months. I took 2 months to practice. And still I used to come across something which showed, again, new method is required here. It will happen with you also. Second one is pretty easy, I think. I also did it. Adi Sharma, they have very beautifully covered this chapter in terms of types. Different type, so illustrative examples, exercise. Another type, illustrative example, exercise. There are around 15 to 16 exercises. Good exercises. Again, we do not know how to integrate product of functions, right?
Yeah.
Even though individually we know what is the integral of tan 2x, 3x and 5x, but unfortunately in the problem they have been multiplied. And I don't know any product rule kind of a thing on integration as of now. So how do I solve this? First, start with the formula of tan 5x. We all know tan 5x can be written as tan 2x plus 3x. Hint, start with this, you will get some clue. Yeah, you have to multiply it very
easily.
Slightly forgot. Think, will recall. So this tan 5x. Take it to the numerator. Yeah. Minus 1 is cos square theta plus 1 minus 2. and divide it by the term in the denominator. Sorry? What happened, Pratik? It was 1 minus cos square first. Sin square is 1 minus cos square, right?
Yeah.
And our minus sign I introduce inside. So 1 minus cos square will become cos square minus 1.
Where did you get that from?
Then I wrote tan as sin by cos and sec as 1 by cos. Then I simplify to this. You will get it. You try it, you get it. Okay. Now, here it is safe because I will get sec x, sec theta, right? Okay.
Yeah.
What about this part? In this part, you multiply with cos theta. Now take cos square theta as, write every cos in the denominator as sine. Okay? Now in this expression take sine theta as t. Okay. So you'll get cos theta d theta as dt. So you'll get 2 dt by 1 minus t square by 2 minus t square. Okay. Which you can write it as, I'll just take some space over here. 1 by 1 minus t square into 2 minus t square. You can write it in a partial fraction form as 1 by 1 minus t square minus 2 minus t square. Subtract, you get 1, right? This is fine. You can write it like this. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
So this you can write 2 integral of 1 by 1 minus t square minus 1 by 2 minus t square. Can you integrate this? Can you integrate that a square minus x square form? Can you integrate this a square minus x square form? So I'm not doing it. Can you manage from there onwards? This problem came in IIT JEE 1987. Okay. So such a simple expression, but look at the complexity involved. Now if I don't give you a break now, some of you may faint. So take a break. On the other side of the break, we'll talk about IVT.